What do you know? We're in the Pyrenees again. I'm really loving this area that falls between Spain and France. We're in the Monster NX Cub again, an ideal plane for the type of flying that I want to do here today. Taking off from a nice grass strip. I'm just going to have a nice, lazy, enjoyable, quiet flight. I'm going to enjoy the beauty and the majesty of this area. It'll be a long flight, probably about 35 minutes total to get to where I want to get to. And I understand most people only watch a couple minutes of a video, so I know maybe a few will watch this in its entirety, or at least a good portion of it. But if nothing else, at least head to the end and see where I'm going to land, where we're heading. A little area that's just, to me, it's really beautiful. It's a fantastic little spot. It's a unique little area to land, and one that's really ideally suited for the Cub, Monster Cub. Big dam down below us. A couple elevation issues with it, but still looks pretty neat. There's another one too that I circle around in one of my other videos. I think it's the high speed tour through the Pyrenees in my T-45 Goshawk. Because sometimes you just have a need for speed, as the old saying goes. And look at this beautiful river that flows through this area. Tell you, there's not that many flat areas like this to land once we get out of this area. So, just kind of some neat buildings. Look like they're built. I wonder if they really like that built into the side of the cliff like that. Such a pretty area. The name of this river. I looked at some maps earlier before starting out on the flight, and I wasn't able to find it. I may still look, and if I find something, I may put it in the description. But it's a very uniquely shaped river, and it's massive actually. It's really, really quite big. And I love finding places like this and just flying close down to the water and close to the shore and just seeing it all go by. Be a nice place to come back with some of the amphibious planes like the Grumman Goose from Big Radials. Area for them. These little beach areas here, there along the river. Like the boats, this might be a nice place to come as well with those. awful lot of little side tributaries that you can go off on here and there. But just going down this main path would be an awful long but very nice sail. I've said it before, but I don't know what I would do without the ability to fly like this. It's just such a perfect way to get away from it all for a little while. Like I said, this flight here today, to get to where we're going, it's probably going to be at least 35, 34. Shaky areas when you're flying over water in the other mountains. Oh, there's a neat bridge over there. Yeah, there's some odd currents going through here. This thing is really shaking funny. Camera's doing a good job of picking up the flight. You know, sometimes the recordings look like they're stuttering, but I don't see that while I'm actually flying. The recording does interfere a little bit with the flight, which makes sense. I mean, I'm recording it on the virtual headset that I'm also flying it on, so it's not being using processing power of the headset itself to record. The agricultural area here, I guess. We're going to get more into the mountains in a little bit. So you can just sit back and relax and enjoy some of the flight. About the turbulence, but when you're flying near mountains and you're in a light plane like this, you're gonna get buffeted a little bit. You just have to expect it. Especially when you get near certain edges of the valleys and the currents decide to start pushing you right up. I think I have now spent probably 5, 6, 7 hours flying in this mountain range. Let's see, I've flown in the BD-5J, the Microjet, the T-45C Goshawk. I think I took the Grumman Goose with the skis, I think, was the other flight. And I think I might have done, another flight with the Cub in another area of the mountain range, an area where there wasn't such large bodies of water. livery that you're seeing on this plane in that outside view is available at flightsim.to. It's the Monster NX Cub STOL Addicts collection. And it's by the Hodge 146. It has five or six liveries with it. This one is called the Silver Cub. Stop buffeting up here. Well, it's still an enjoyable flight. And I have been for the last few days, and all the flights that I've posted, all the videos that I've uploaded, the last 2 or 3 days, I think maybe 7, 8 videos, 9 videos, probably amount to a total of 20 hours of flying since World Update 8 was released and I installed it. So I have not had any issues, no crashes. Everything has worked exactly as I expected to, and everything operating normally. The graphics, as you can see, are very, very nice. This area was part of the update, so the Pyrenees Mountains were part of the Sim Update 8. And I also have been running with the latest NVIDIA graphics driver that also was updated just, I think, a day or two before the update was set, 8, like right before, a day or two before it. And so this is the latest NVIDIA graphics driver that I'm also running. And I think the Oculus Quest, now that I think about it, I think my Oculus Quest finally caught update to version 38. I think the Oculus Quest. Yeah. I think that also updated within the last few days. So a couple new planes, a couple updates, and you mix it all together, and sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't, but so far I've been very, very fortunate. Like I said, at least 20 hours now flying since Sim Update 8. And you can see evidence of it in the past 6 or 7 videos that I've uploaded to my channel. For those of you that are actually still watching this and will hear me speaking, thank you very much for watching. But that's okay if you don't, because I put these up so that I can sit back and enjoy them myself. Flights. I record almost every flight just because it seems like I see something amazing in every flight that I want to see again or I want to share. I don't know if I'll ever get to the point where being able to fly around the world like this in virtual reality becomes boring or non-exciting. Now we're getting more into the mountains, my favorite area to fly. does have a way of making you feel small and insignificant. That's all granite over there. Kind of like El Capitan in Yosemite National Parks. Another beautiful, beautiful place to fly. I have a couple of flights up that canyon in El Capitan and Half Dome and all the many, many landmarks of that area. Well, we're getting there. We're more than halfway to my secret landing spot. It's so secret, I hope I can find it again. Well, you'll see it's really needed. We got some clouds along the tops of the mountains here, so might make it a little difficult getting into my spot. If there's clouds like this around there, we could be in the clear when we get there, we'll see. Amazing, you could have so many, many different weather patterns in the mountains. And all very, very close proximity to each other. Mountain top down to a mountain valley to the next mountain top, you could have three different I just noticed that one of my fuel tanks was getting lower than the other, so I want to switch to kind of balance, let it balance out. You know, you can be flying along this ridge, and on the right side be like the Arctic, and on the left side it's like the Amazon. really is a unique mountain range and really, really magnificent to fly in. I hope some of you are still with me on this flight. But if not, that's okay, because I'm enjoying the daylights out of it, like I do every flight. One of the most enjoyable things to me right now that I have available to me. And I'm not saying that as like, oh, it's the only thing I got, it's terrible. I'm saying that with a great love for this application, this program. If you've watched any of my other videos, you'll know I've been flight simming now for well over 25 years, I think. Yeah, more than 25 years now. Every version of Microsoft Flight Sim from day one till today, I've owned and have flown. Quite frankly, not a single one of them prepared me for Microsoft Flight Sim 2020 in virtual reality. Even when I purchased it, I never in my wildest dreams was thinking virtual reality. I was just thinking the incredible graphics on a 4K monitor. That's weird. That's actually a fault in the map. I don't know. Never in my wildest dreams though did I think virtual reality. And now I really can't think of flying any other way. Although I am thinking more and more of getting a really nice, wide, high-def, curved monitor. As long as I can get decent graphics with it. My laptop doesn't have all the display ports on it because I wasn't planning on ever plugging anything in, so it has an HDMI and like flying over mountaintops like this that are all just solid rock. No trees. The bones of the earth sticking all the way up into the sky. Oh, I'm waxing poetic there for a minute. Oh, man, I've got to pay attention. If you're on mountain peaks at the same level that I'm flying, and I am now flying. So we're getting down to one of those areas that I was telling you about, though, where it's like you look to the right and you think you're in the Alaska or Antarctica, and then you look to the left and you think you're flying over the Amazon. There's some definitely funky wind currents that you can get through some of these areas. And I've been feeling it almost this entire flight. It's been like no smooth. But looking at the clouds, that's not surprising. These types of clouds get pushed up and there's that better mode. With these clouds, you can see they're being pushed up and fattened. Ready for this? You see that pond down there that's at about 12 o'clock right now? We're going to be landing right next to this. It's a little bumpy, and I'll actually probably bounce a couple of times, but it won't be because I'm bouncing, it's just because of the shape of the ground. Luckily, this cadet can stop in a very, very short distance, so we can limit the amount of bumps that we have to take here. Here we go. We've lost a bit of speed. No flaps. Bumpy, but don't worry, it's okay. It's a safe spot. And it's a really nice spot. Okay. Yeah, see what I mean? See, we kind of hit the bump and then flew over the edge. But here we are, in this incredible latest place. What a place to be able to come to. How could you do it without an airplane and without this sim? I wouldn't even know this existed. Look at this place though. All right, let's get out of the plane.